The prepared ammonia from Haber's process will be dried. Will be dried. That means the quantity of water which may be present with ammonia will be eliminated out. Okay, by using quick lime or calcium oxide. That means that to remove the water percentage of prepared ammonia from Haber's process, so the ammonia is passed over quick lime or calcium oxide. This quick lime or calcium oxide is useful to absorb water percentage from prepared ammonia of Haber's process. Next one, but to dry the prepared ammonia from Haber's process, it is not proposed to use concentrated sulfuric acid or anhydrous calcium chloride or P4O10. What are all these? These three are most important dehydrating agent. They are also eliminate water molecule. But in case of ammonia, the use of these concentrated sulfuric acids, anhydrous calcium chlorides, phosphorus pentoxides are not proposed to dry ammonia because these three reagents may react with ammonia. So this is the reason why, due to reactivity of concentrated sulfuric acid, anhydrous calcium chloride, phosphorus pentoxide with ammonia, it is not good to dry ammonia in such condition. Next one, let us learn about properties. Properties of ammonia. So we have to learn that ammonia is a colorless gas with pungent smell or pungent odor. It is a colorless gas with pungent odor. Here it is having freezing point nearly 195.2 degree Kelvin. Freezing point of ammonia is 195.2 degree Kelvin, whereas melting point of ammonia is 239.7 degree Kelvin. The freezing point 195.2 Kelvin degree Kelvin, whereas the melting point of ammonia is 239.7 degree Kelvin. In liquid state and solid state, hydrogen bonding present or identified in ammonia, like in case of water. What is the important statement? In liquid state and solid state, what will be expected during the liquid state and solid state? In liquid state and solid state, the spatial distance between two ammonia molecules may be less when compared to in case of gaseous state. Hence, there is a attraction between hydrogen atom of one ammonia, nitrogen atom of another ammonia. The resulting bond is called as hydrogen bond. The bond between hydrogen and more electronegative atom is called as hydrogen bond. So this hydrogen bond mostly identified in liquid state and solid state of ammonia than gaseous state. Only the reason why it is identified only in liquid state and solid state is, in liquid state and solid state, the spatial distance between ammonia are close to each other. When they are close to each other, the nitrogen atom of one ammonia and hydrogen atom of another ammonia molecule interact with each other and forms hydrogen bond in case of, like in case of water. Due to presence of hydrogen bonding in ammonia increases melting point and boiling point. Due to presence of these hydrogen bonding in between two ammonia molecules, especially in liquid and solid state, increases melting points and boiling point when compared to its original molecular mass. When compared to its original molecular mass, because urea will have 60 molecular weight or 60 molecular mass. As per the statement, those chemical substances which will have lesser molecular masses have to be with less melting points and less boiling point. But opposite to the statement, ammonia will have greater melting points and greater boiling points. This condition will be explained by taking hydrogen bonding phenomenon. Next, ammonia is with pyramidal shape. Ammonia is with pyramidal shape. So I will show you how ammonia structure will be present. N, here is one hydrogen, one more hydrogen, and these are the lone pair electrons or non-bonding pair of electrons. Are present at nitrogen. Now these three hydrogens are arranged like trigonal at the bottom. So 1, 2, 3 hydrogens. At the center of these three hydrogens, at the top side, nitrogen present. Onto the nitrogen top side, lone pair electrons or non-bonding pair of electrons are present. Entirely, it seems to be pyramid structure. Hence, it is called as pyramidal shape. So, in this pyramidal shape of nitrogen, NH bond will have 107.8 picometers. Sorry for this. The NH bond length in ammonia is 101.7 picometers. What is bond length? The distance between nucleus of nitrogen and nucleus of hydrogen is called as NH bond length. The amount of NH bond length is 101.7 picometers. So we know that 1 picometer is equals to 1 into 10 to the power of 12 meters. A very less quantity. Okay, 1 picometer is equals to 1 into 10 to the power of minus 12 meters. So the distance from nitrogen to hydrogen, nitrogen nucleus to hydrogen nucleus, is called as bond length. It is 101.7 picometers. And bond angle. What is bond angle here? The angle present in between nitrogen with two hydrogen, or HNH, this is called bond angle. So the bond angle present is 107.8 degrees. The bond length is 101.7 picometers, and bond angle is 101.7 picometers of bond length, and bond angle is 107.8 degrees. Next one, ammonia will show pyramidal shape with nitrogen atom
at the apex. Nitrogen atom at the apex. So at the top of these three hydrogen, nitrogen present. And in ammonia, around the nitrogen, around the nitrogen atom, or in nitrogen atom, six bonded electrons and two non-bonding electrons present. Non-bonding electrons present. The total amount of electrons around the ammonia at nitrogen are 6 plus 2, 8. So, by following octet rule, it seems to be stable. So, once again, three pairs of bonded electrons and one pair of non-bonding electrons present. So the two statements are same. Here we are using pairs to express number of electron around the nitrogen of ammonia, whereas here we are using individual number of electrons, six bonded